Hey guys, this is Dr. Nikunjan and you are watching Doctor Class. So in today's session, we will discuss about the general terminology which is used for the understanding of anatomy. So let's start with the position first. Okay, so in today's lecture, we will discuss about the position like anatomical position, supine position, prone position, recumbent position, and last but not the least about the lithotomy. So let's start with the anatomical position first. So anatomical position is the position in which a person has to stand upright. A person has to stand upright with palm facing forward direction, right? Palm should be faced in a forward direction as well as leg straight. Okay, so this is the feature of the anatomical position. Basically, anatomical position is very important to determine the different positions as well. Right, so let us look. So this is another figure which represents the anatomical position. So you can see that the person is stand upright as well as the palm face in a forward direction as well as the straighted lower limbs. Now, let's look on other terminologies we can understood by the anatomical position. Now, an axis, a straight axis which gives a line which divide body into right and the left compartment, right sided body and the left sided body. So that line which is present in the mid of a body is known as the midline. Okay. And the plane pass from this midline is known as medial plane, or you can say median plane. Okay, so here what we find that a midline can cut body into right and the left part, right? A plane pass from the midline is known as the median plane. What are the different terminology we can assume from the mid plane? Right, this median plane is very important. Okay, by the median plane we can also distribute on terminology like lateral and the medial. Okay, so basically lateral and medial, these are comparative terminology to each other. Let's see how. If I'm talking about the various organs, okay, so those organs which are much closer to the midline than other one, right? So the closer organ, closer to the midline, closer organ is known as the medial in the comparison of this far one. Clear? So in other words, the parts present, the body part present nearer to the midline or a median plane, they are known as the medials. And those parts which are present far from the body midline, so they are known as the laterals. Okay, so the laterals and medials are comparative to each other, right? So let's see the next figure. Here what we find, this one is the prone position, this is the supine position. So prone position is the position when a person lies on a trunk or a ventral surface and the dorsal surface or a back should face upward. Here what you find that during the supine position, person has to lie on a back, or you can say a dorsal surface. So here ventral surface could be face upright. Okay, so either say that the prone position and the supine position is opposite to each other. The next thing is the right lateral recumbent and the left lateral recumbent. First of all, recumbent position is represent when a person lie on the side of his or her abdomen. Clear? Right. So here we are finding the right lateral as well as the left lateral recumbent position. When a person lies with the head up with flexion of the hip, this position is known as the Fowler's position. And the another position in which a person lie by the head downward and the feet upward, they are known as the Trendelenburg position. So the Trendelenburg position basically applied during some clinical condition like a gynecological procedure or the sporting during the pregnancy, or you can say early phase of pregnancy. So the next figure shows you in the lithotomy position. This is very important. This position is known as the lithotomy. This kind of lithotomy position is basically used for the gynecological procedure as well as the normal delivery. Right? So let's see the next thing. Planes. So we are finishing here with the positions. Now we have to talk about the planes. So basically there are three types of plane. One is transverse plane, median plane and coronal plane. We already discussed about the median plane during the midline. Okay, right? We are already discussed about the median plane during discussion of a midline. Now we have to see the transverse plane and the coronal plane. Let's look. Okay, if we cut body, from this plane, okay, so that this plane is known as what? The median plane. A plane pass vertically from the axis of body is known as the median plane. A plane pass horizontally from the abdomen, which cut body into upper part and the lower part, they are known as the transverse plane, where a plane pass from the sagittal section of a body and cut it into the anterior and the posterior way, or you can say another terminology, anteriors are known as a ventral, posteriors are known as a dorsal. So they are known, this that plane is known as the coronal plane. Let's look. Okay, so this is the figure represent this all three planes. The plane pass from the axis of body is known as a median plane. A plane pass horizontally from the axis of body is known as a transverse plane. And the plane pass and divide body into anterior and the posterior compartment, they are known as the coronal plane. Right. So here we are not that much cleared about the coronal plane, but wait a minute. Okay. Right. So first see the relative terminology and afterward we will look on the furthermore understanding of a coronal plane as well. Okay. So let's see the ventral. Ventral means what? Ventral means anterior. Okay. Basically ventral is the representer for the anterior part. The dorsal is for a posterior part. So this anterior and posterior part of body is divided by the plane known as the coronal plane. So the another feature is the medial and the lateral. We already discussed about this, right? The organ or a part of a body which is nearer to the midline, they are known as a medial one, and those who are far away from the midline, they are known as the lateral one. The another one is the proximal and distal. Let's look about the proximal and the distal. Okay. So basically proximal and distal are also comparative terminology as like the medial and the lateral. Proximal part is those part who are situated at the origin of a limb. Basically if we are discussing about the limb proximality and the distality, so we can say a part present at the origin of the limb if we are talking about the upper limb. So the shoulder region is that region which is the origin part of the upper limb. So it is known as the proximal one. And the phalanx, these phalanx are basically a part which are parts present far from the origin or at the end point, they are known as the distal one. Then the superficial and deep one. Superficial parts are those who are situated much above at the level of skin. Right, and the deep structure below the skin is known as the deep parts. Clear? Let's look by this figure first one. Okay, so here you can easily make a midline. So you can easily divide the body into right and left by the medial plane. Okay, so this one is right, this one is left. What you can other see that this is the transverse plane. Okay, this is the transverse plane by which body can be divided into the upper part and the lower part. The upper part is consists head and thorax as well as some part of abdomen, where the lower part is consists of the perineum, some part of abdomen, perineum, as well as the lower limb. Now let's look that the part which is the direction which goes upside is known as the superior direction. Okay, parts upside is known as the superior one, right? So superior end are sometimes known as the cranial end. They are sometimes known as the cranial end, where the inferior parts below towards the ground or towards the feet are known as the inferior one, and sometimes these inferior are known as the caudal end. Okay, so now let's see on another figure, right? So from this figure, from this position, we can easily see the median plane and the transverse plane. But what about the coronal plane? So you can see here the coronal plane. Okay, so this plane is what? The coronal plane. By the coronal plane, body can be divided into anterior and posterior. Anterior one is the ventral and the posterior one is the dorsal here. Okay, so let's look on next terminologies. Okay, so this is also on a kind of same figure who determine the positions of midline, transverse plane. This one is the coronal plane, anterior, posterior, medial, lateral. Clear? Right, cranial end is also known as the superior one, caudal is the inferior one. This structure present upside on a graph or upside on a screen is known as the superficial structure. More below than the skin, inside is known as a deeper one. Okay, so these are the very normal terminology we can use in general anatomy. Let's see the ipsilateral, contralateral first, right? So before understanding the ipsilateral and the contralateral, you have to understand the unilateral and the bilateral. Unilateral and bilateral. So unilateral is means what? A part at a one side. Part at a one side is known as the unilateral. Part as on a both side, they are known as a bilateral, right? So what about the ipsilateral? So ipsilateral condition is used, the term is used for the determination of the limbs generally. Okay, so if I talk about the limbs, upper limb, these are the upper limb and these are the lower limb. Okay, so both the upper limb and lower limb of a same side are known as an ipsilateral one, right? Our vision of part or our interest of part of interest is of upper and lower limb, but at the same side they are known as the ipsilateral to each other. But if we talk about the part contra to each other, if upper limb is of the right side and the lower limb of the left side, they are conjointly known as the contralateral to each other. Are you getting me what I mean? Right, so this is the funda of ipsilateral and contralateral. So ipsilateral and contralateral, these are the terminologies basically used during the understanding of epileptic or conditions like a convulsions. Right, the next thing is invagination and evagination. Now on our skin or in any tissues, there are various depressions are there. Okay, if the depression is above side, right, or depression is upward, it will lead the elevation. Or the depression below or a downward side, it will lead to the groove, formation of groove. Okay, so depression upward and lead to the elevation, that kind of depression are known as evagination. And those depression which lead to the formation of groove, they are known as the invagination. Are you getting me what I mean? Right, so let's next. Anterior means the ventral, posterior means the dorsal, right? Medial border and the lateral border. Medial border, this two terminology is relative to a particular organ. Right, if I talk about the arm, so what do you mean by this? If we talk about the forearm, then the forearm consists the radial border and the ulnar border. So this ulna, basically this ulna is more towards the midline, so it is the medial border of forearm, and this one is far from the medial border, midline. So this one is known as the lateral border of forearm. Okay, so basically medial border, lateral border, these are the comparative term. Again say that these are the comparative terms. Okay, right, it can be applied when the second thing is there. Let's see the fundamentals of unilateral, bilateral, ipsilateral and contralateral. A part on one side is known as a unilateral, a part on both sides, same, is known as a bilateral, but a part of a different limb on the same side, they are known as ipsilateral. Part on a differently of both the limbs but at a different side, one is right, one is left, so they are known as a contralateral parts. Clear? Let's see next. Okay, so invagination means what? Invagination means a projection inside. Projection inside, so there that will create a groove. So that means it is invagination. But if the depression is below or upside, and it will lead the projection, or you can say elevation, that will, it is known as the evagination. Is it clear? Ventral means the anterior, which is a frontal aspect, where the dorsal and the posterior is the back aspect. Okay, so these are the generalized things.